baseball coach here at Southeastern Oklahoma State University. I've been the head coach now for 30, this is my 35th season, so I've been around for a long time. I was also a player at Southeastern and also a graduate assistant at Southeastern, so that's close to 40 years, I guess. I'm getting late in my career. We're not having a great year right now, but hopefully this weekend it'll get better for us. Why did I become a baseball coach? I was a player at Southeastern, and I have always enjoyed baseball, and just felt like that as long as I could stay around the game, that's what I wanted to do. Of course, I wanted to be a professional player and wasn't good enough to do that, so I stayed here at Southeastern, played 4 years for Dr. Parham, and then I was his graduate assistant for a year. And then I got married right after my senior year, and my wife and I moved to New Mexico, and we knew that that wasn't going to be the place to stay, so we moved back to Clayton, Oklahoma, where I was a baseball coach there for 4 years. And at that time, Dr. Parham came to visit, said he had an opening for an assistant coach and wanted to know if I came back, and wanted to come back. And so because I wanted to stay in baseball, then I decided that I would move back to Southeastern. I was an assistant for 5 years, and Dr. Parham retired, and I became a baseball coach in 1981. When I recruit baseball players, I like guys that are good students. They have to have, you know, good grades to get in Southeastern, and they have to maintain those grades, so I look for a guy that will go to class. And unfortunately, sometimes kids drop out of school because they don't follow through with going to class or getting their work done, but we like guys that are dependable, want to go to class. We, of course, like guys that have great baseball talent, and we like guys that get along with each other, team players, and so there's just a lot of qualities that you look for when you're out recruiting. I guess the person that had the greatest influence on my life was Dr. Parham. Dr. Don Parham was athletic director and baseball coach at Southeastern for many, many years. And as I said, I came to Southeastern without any scholarship, without any knowledge of whether I was going to play or not. And my first year, I became a starter on the team, and Doc was a outstanding mentor to me and outstanding coach, and I learned just a tremendous amount from being around Dr. Parham, and I was just fortunate to be, I think, a guy that he kind of took under his wing, and I think he enjoyed having me around him. We were good friends on and off the field and very close, and so he probably had the greatest effect on my baseball career. Other guys that, you know, have motivated me through the years, but I would go back to Dr. Parham as the one who did that. And if a baseball player, if he, the question is, how can baseball help a student in life? I think it goes back to the dependability, whether he goes to class, whether he's dependable to get his work done. Like a guy that gets along with his teammates real well, and the teachers, you know, we just like a good guy around campus. We don't want a guy that's always in trouble. And so all of these things give a player discipline, and I think that in the long run is something that will help them in later life, so that the discipline that they learn here at Southeastern maybe can help them later on. That's about it.